I'm David with Brazos Valley Barbell, and today I wanted to follow a couple of the last videos that I've been making with maybe some more concrete things about how to design programming. And so in the last couple of videos, the first one we were talking about the mechanics of deadlifting, and then we went into the ways to design a block for those. And I wanted to show what I've been doing recently with my block design in a way that has led to some good success for myself and a lot of my lifters. So what we're doing right now is, what we're wanting to look at with this chart is the blue line is going to be the volume, the red line is going to be the average load, or just the average percentage of my one rep max that's on the bar, and then the more purple line is going to be the intensity, or essentially the proximity to failure that I am. And I'll throw up what my spreadsheets actually look like, so you can get maybe a better representation of this on a weekly basis. There's going to be other charts that are over on the right hand side that are about the percentages that I'm spending, or the amount of times that I'm spending in different loading zones for each of the lifts, and how I design the lifts individually. So with this block right now, I'm really prioritizing my deadlift, and so even within that, I'm prioritizing my deadlift, and I'm trying to hit some heavy loading here at week 3 and week 7, but I'm far enough away from a competition, or I'm heading into a competition that really is going to be, so with this eight week block, the competition is at week 11, but it's a fairly low priority competition in my annual plan. So this block would just be kind of a standard strength block that I would do in the regular course of training, but not really leading you into competition. As you can see, the volume isn't really dropping off very drastically. So I'm not really trying to hit the peak form numbers, but I'm really trying to hit a lot of heavy loading, but under much higher fatigue. And so I'm trying to drive up my work capacity and get a lot of those heavy lifts in basically less than ideal circumstances. So what we're gonna look at right here is how the programming was set up, specifically at my deadlifting programming on my primary deadlift day. So even though it's my primary deadlift day, I'm still hitting a lot of stuff before it. So with my frequency of 3 times squatting a week, my high bar squatting, or my accessory squatting day, I usually do before my deadlifts. And a lot of the lifters we have doing their primary deadlifts following some sort of lighter variation of squatting. So what we're doing here is I still am working up to a set of five, a heavy set of five on my high bar squats at an 8 RPE, followed by my high bar pause squats at a 72.5%. With some close grip bench pressing at a light percentage, and then my heavy deadlifts. So I'm working up to a heavy single on deadlifts at 90%, and really that single is not meant to be a very taxing single. It's meant to be kind of a primer. It gives me a little bit of practice at heavier loading, but really not enough to fatigue me for my real working sets down here. So as you can see with the volume, I'm really not letting volume drop off a whole bunch on any of these lifts, or really at all. On these lifts, my intensity is going up across the board, but with this variation, this high bar squat variation, even though it's challenging and fatiguing for me, it's still not as heavy as if I were doing the same loading in the low bar squat. It may be more fatiguing on my lower back in the low bar squat, but I get a good training effect in my quads and my back that really transfers well to deadlifting from me having to support the bar on my back in a less efficient position, and then my quads. Building my stronger quads has made a big difference in my deadlift success. So with the objective of building up to a heavy 3 rep max on deadlift at the end of this program, I still, because I'm in a normal training block, am not going to sacrifice volume during my high bar squatting or that lighter close grip bench pressing just to be able to hit a heavy set here. So obviously I want this set to be as good as possible, but in the normal process of training, I don't want to make the sacrifices that will slow down my progress long term. So with things like Raw Nationals or competitions going into early next year, this block means a lot more to me to maintain volume across the board now than it does to actually hit peak performance at the meet here in the summer. So we're working up to again heavy maxes, which actually was a personal record high bar squat for the 485 pounds for 5 reps with a little room to spare right there. Followed by 5 sets of 5 with 425 pounds on the pause squats. The high bar squat is something that I feel like I'm really bad at, but putting it in my training and making it really driving the intensity on that one has I've seen a big impact on my on both my deadlift and my regular competition squat. So that's been something that I've been including a lot more of. And so this was about a 10-pound increase from week to week. So the volume stayed relatively high, intensity got higher, but through the progressions was able to work up from 725 pounds on these 2 days to hitting a big personal record of 750 pounds for a triple, which is only 22 pounds off of the American record that I currently hold. So hitting these loads in training and following the progression allowed me to be able to represent some strength there, but we're nowhere near what would actually be in competition. So this is something that's a big deal through normal training processes. We wanna work it. We wanna drive the intensity and drive the loads that we're using.
But hitting these numbers in training does mean a lot more down the road, but I can't sacrifice for the volume for the training personal records now.
So looking at the program design on a weekly basis, like I said, Monday is the primary deadlift day, but I'm still squatting three times a week, so that will include that light squat variation. It also includes the close grip variation at a lighter weight to get into my four sessions a week of bench pressing. This day, this day one day, is a very, very fatiguing session, especially after working up to a three rep max after all the volume that I did before it. So I have to plan my week accordingly. So I have to anticipate the sessions after it, whether they're lower body or upper body sessions, basically being diminished because of the fatigue that I accumulated from this single session and from all of the sessions that I've done before it. So right after my day one day, I do the two easiest days in my week, which would be a light volume bench press day. And this may be something like five sets of eight at something like, 67, 70%, where I am still getting a good amount of volume training in right there, but not enough to where my training is really going to be impacted from the day before and where I can still recover from it pretty well. So the day three would just be a recovery day and maybe an accessory day, like a back accessory day with pull-ups or those kind of things. Just light stuff I need to work on. But this would be more like five sets of five at 70% or something on squat. So I still am accumulating some volume right there, but the RP is low. You know, it's the perceived exertion is going to be around a five or so. And so we still progress that one from week to week, but generally I try to keep, maybe I'll start it four sets of five, and the next week maybe five sets of four, and then six sets of three, with the weight increasing each time, but the intensity stays lower. So I can drive some the intensity up, get a little bit more practice under a little bit more weight, but not enough to fatigue me too much heading into my heavier sets down here. So day four and day five are my primary bench, my primary squat day. These can be manipulated some. I think a lot of lifters may do well with this day four being after day five and just taking another rest day right here to get a little bit more recovery from some of the benching that was done earlier in the week. For me, my squats are fatiguing enough for me, and my elbows and shoulders get beat up enough from squatting that I don't like following my bench press workout with my squat. So this seems to be the best fit as far as when my bench press is included in there. So those may be, follow a similar structure as what I did with my deadlifts there, is I will do singles or triples or something as top sets and then heavier working loads throughout my working sets. And same thing with my squats. So some of the key points that I think people should look at when they're designing programming is that you need to, with every block, with every block that you're designing, with every day, with each exercise, define what you're trying to get out of the day or out of the block. So with this block, I'm trying to increase the loading. I'm trying to drive intensity, but I'm not willing to sacrifice volume yet. So if I would have come up to this top set triple, and I said triple at 9.5 RPE, obviously going into the day, I wanted it to be a big personal record, and the 750 was the number I had in mind. But if this day would have been hard and I would have had too much fatigue from the stuff before it, I wouldn't have needed to sacrifice the squats before it to make this happen, because that would slow down my long-term goals. So the objective is to build to a three rep max, it's to build volume, it's to increase the loading on all these lifts, but it's not necessarily to hit that 750 for a triple right now and sacrifice the progress long-term. So with the block, we need to plan ahead. And so we need to think about the intensity that's coming and not sacrifice some of the
the loading earlier on. So while we do need to include intensity and we do need to drive intensity, the sport of powerlifting is defined by the most weight I can lift. And so just hanging out in those low RPE ranges is not going to have as much of a carryover. So we can see that I'm building even on my high bar squat to very heavy loading, and here it's to very heavy loading. But in these sessions may have felt great on my deadlift, and so it would have been tempting for me to, while I had lower fatigue from my squatting, go ahead and go for a max effort single or a max effort triple. But that really just sacrifices the training effect that I'm trying to get from this week before my taper and before repeating the process. So don't let your short-term goals get in the way of what you said your objective was for the block. And think about priorities as far as your meets and what you're trying to get out of the block that you're in. And you'll set yourself up for a lot of success down the road. So if you plan intentionally and plan slowly, you'll get a lot more out of your training instead of just hitting these 9.5 RPEs every day. And instead of it being a 750 triple here at the end of the week, it may have been 725 for a triple all the way across, and not been able to finish all of my working sets. And so my volume would have suffered and my fatigue would have been too high, and my performance is going to end up suffering later. So just be deliberate, be smart with your training. If you want to find me on Instagram, see what my athletes are doing, you can either follow me at David Woolson, or Brazos Valley Barbell is where a lot of the coaching takes place. So thanks for watching, and let me know if you have any questions.